In today's segment, I'll be discussing about Ellingham diagram. Ellingham diagram is an important concept in metallurgy. It provides a graphical representation of Gibbs energy. It is nothing but a graph of delta G versus T. Delta G versus T graph. It provides information for considering the choice of reducing agent. Ellingham diagram, it provides information for considering the choice of reducing agent in the reduction of oxides. It helps us, this Ellingham diagram helps us in predicting the feasibility of thermal reduction of an ore. And it also gives information for the criterion of feasibility at a given temperature, that the Gibbs energy of the reaction must be negative. Ellingham diagram normally consists of plots of delta G versus T for formation of oxides of elements, that is for the reaction. For the reaction, M plus O2 gives MXO. In this equation, in this reaction, the gaseous amount, that is molecular randomness, is decreasing from left to right due to the consumption of gases, leading to a negative value of delta S. Delta S is randomness. Delta S is entropy, change in entropy, which changes the sign of the second term. Which changes the sign of the second term means in this equation, that is delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S minus T delta S. Subsequently, delta G shifts towards higher side despite rising temperature. Normally, delta G decreases, that is it goes to the lower side with increasing temperature. Delta G is nothing but the change in Gibbs energy. The result is positive slope in the curve for most of the reactions shown above for the formation of MXO. Here, each plot is a straight line. Each plot is a straight line except when some change in phase, that is solid to liquid or liquid to gas, takes place. The temperature at which such change occurs is indicated by an increase in the slope on the positive side. This here, the phase change occurs. For example, in this curve, the melting is indicated by the abrupt change in the curve. If you see this line, ZnO line, the melting is indicated by an abrupt change in the curve. This is where the phase change occurs. There's a point in the curve below which delta G is negative. Above this point, MXO will decompose, the metal oxide will decompose on its own. In an Ellingham diagram, the plots of delta G versus T, delta G, the plots of delta G for oxidation of common metals and some reducing agents are given over here. The values of delta G at different temperatures are depicted, which make the interpretation very easy. If you see the limitations of Ellingham diagram, the graph simply indicates, this graph simply indicates whether a reaction is possible or not. That is, the tendency of reduction with the reducing agent is indicated. This is because it is based only on the thermodynamic concepts. It does not say about the kinetics of the reduction process. And then the interpretation of delta G naught is based on K. That is the equation delta G is equal to minus RT ln K. We have learned this in equilibrium. This is presumed that the reactions and products are in equilibrium. We know the equation MXO plus A gives XM plus AO. Where this is not always true. This is because the reactant or product may be solid. However, it explains how the reactions are sluggish when every species is in solid state and smooth when the ore melts down. And it is also interesting to note that delta H is nothing but the enthalpy change, and delta S is the entropy change. These values for any chemical reaction remain nearly constant even on varying temperature. So the only dominant variable in equation becomes T, that is temperature. And delta S depends much on the physical state of the compound. Since entropy depends on disorderliness or randomness in the system, it will increase, entropy increases if a compound melts. That is, when it changes from solid to liquid or vaporizes, that is, liquid to gas. Since molecular randomness increases on changing the phase from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas.